All right, so it's the day after Thanksgiving. We're up here at the cabin in Tioga County, Pennsylvania. Rifle season here in Pennsylvania starts tomorrow. And we actually got up here to camp on Wednesday night late, spent the day yesterday for Thanksgiving, just hanging out here, eating some good food, had a good time. And today, the day before the season, we are gonna shoot some guns, make sure all our rifles are sighted in, get some practice in, and then tomorrow we'll be out hunting, so we're looking forward to it. So right now, it's our whole family's here at the cabin now, except for Brady and Amber. They're gonna be getting here today. So I'm gonna be hunting, basically all of us are gonna be hunting except for Brady. Me, Preston, Carter, Marcus, Dawson, and Dad are all gonna be out tomorrow. I'm probably gonna hunt public land, and maybe one of my brothers will come to public land with me, and other than that, the rest of the guys will be here.
You guys cross my foot there.
We got Dad out there setting up a target, and we're gonna sit here, set up on this table, shoot about 100 yards. Even though really the majority of your shots here for deer hunting in Pennsylvania, at least for what we do, like here in the big woods, in the mountains, most of our shots are gonna be a lot closer than this. There's some places where some guys probably do long range hunting, but for the most part, Pennsylvania deer hunters, it's a lot of close range stuff.
So Preston, Marcus, Dawson, and I don't know where Carter is, but he's somewhere.
We've done some hunting here in archery season. Me and Preston did a lot of hunting during the rut. Saw some bucks, didn't shoot any. Brady was the only one in our family who shot a buck during archery season, on opening day actually, out here in one of the food plots. So he is the only one without a buck tag, so he won't really be doing any hunting. So the rest of us are gonna be buck hunting here this weekend. We'll be staying, or at least some of us will be staying for Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. This is the first year that we are allowed to hunt on Sunday here in Pennsylvania. This first Sunday of deer season is one of the three Sundays that they opened for hunting here in Pennsylvania this year.
All set up out there, Dad?
Oh yeah, ready to roll, man.
All right, there's Carter.
Carter got the towels.
He got the towels for us.
You know what? Do we have our sandbag to prop on?
Yeah, we should grab that.
Yeah.
What are you looking at?
Morris, I tried to. They wouldn't tie if I did.
Okay, now you're trying to take footage of him? You're making fun of him, now you're gonna try to take footage of him.
Better. Where's the clip?
Hey, loud boys. See, this is gonna get loud. Boss.
How'd it feel, Meeks?
Felt pretty good. I don't know if I got a good shot, though.
You think you're going to shoot the big buck tomorrow, Meeks?
I think I might have to. He certainly won't. That's enough.
Look at that fool.
Look
at that joker. What the heck?
They saw us.
Texas and Iowa State are playing right now. That's a 15 versus a 20.
How's that suit there, Mix?
It's pretty good.
Notre Dame, North Carolina this afternoon.
Yeah, I haven't.
It's crazy.
I think my sister-in-law's well. I think my mom will. I just had at Middle Creek Monday night. And I mean, like, she.
All right, we had some good dinner. Looks like we got some desserts back here, too. Let's take a look.
What do we got here, mates?
It looks like we had a coconut cream pie.
Some chocolate chip cookies, M&M cookies, some Tandy cake bars, pecan pie.
Can't stop.
Good morning, everybody. It is the opening day of the PA rifle season. I am about 2.25 miles in already. I have about 45 minutes till daylight. I'm down here in the bottom of this valley, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sneak up to this flat that's behind me and see if there's any deer feeding out in there. We've seen some good bucks in that area in the past, and if I don't see anything there, I'm gonna sneak around the point and check a bedding area that we know about. If we don't see anything there, I'm just going to push a little bit towards where we parked this morning and set up in a saddle. A lot of hunting pressure gets pushed down from that parking area, and they like to go through that saddle to bed in the bedding area that we know about. So I'm going to try and cut the distance between them, and hopefully we're seeing some deer today. Should be an awesome day in the woods. The weather is pretty nice. We have light rain, which makes it great for sneaking, and we have winds out of the west, which is perfect coming from the parking area down to where I'm at. So it's hit me right in the face, which is awesome. And about 40, 45 degrees today. So hopefully we're seeing some deer soon. We've been hunting hard in archery season, and it just feels good to get a gun in our hands again. So hopefully we're seeing some deer, and I don't know how much I'll be able to film today. I won't be able to film much when I'm sneaking, but when I get set up in that saddle, if it gets to that point, I'll for sure put the camera on the tripod, and we'll give you an update from there.
Well, folks, what a crazy day yet again. Dad and I seem to have some pretty crazy adventures down here on this public piece. We're about a mile and a half to 2 miles in right now. Dad shot this buck this morning, and we weren't quite sure about the hit, and Dad tracked it. I went and hunted a different spot up this valley, and Dad wasn't quite sure about the hit, so we waited about 2 hours, and he started tracking around noon, which was about 2 hours after the shot. Found three beds and actually bumped the deer, and the deer came down out of this valley right here, and he heard some loud crashing, and he never saw the deer after that. He just heard the crashing, and so what we did was I sent him back over to where he had shot the buck this morning, and I was going to try and push everything back around to him because I thought this buck might be bedded in this beach. He wasn't. What happened was he crashed and fell dead in the creek. And boy, oh boy, he is a dandy. Oh man, that fires me up. Just the amount of excitement there. Here comes Dad now. Yeah, buddy. That is a dandy. Oh man. He was dead, but I wanted to make sure.
Is that where he was?
He was dead right there. He is a dandy.
Holy
crap. That might be your biggest. Wow. Look at the brow tines on that thing. Oh my word.
Big old mountain buck.
That is a big mountain buck. I wonder if we have him on camera. I'd have to look.
Look at Daddy.
We're gonna have to get some pictures again in the creek, but that is a monster. That is awesome. Oh,
well,
man.
When he was chasing the doe, yeah, the sun was in there.
Okay.
And I knew he had time.
Yeah.
I couldn't tell how big he was. It was just like, yeah, he was moving and chasing him around.
He's got mass. And look at it. His G2s are bladed.
I know.
Oh, a, man.
That buck. Holy shit. That's a man. Thank you, man. Yep. I'll bring you along again.
Holy, oh, that is massive. Okay. That is a monster.
It is.
Public land.
Mountain buck.
Look at that. Oh, my goodness.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
She locked up and he didn't know what to do. So he went right after her. And
I
squeezed one off.
Yeah, Brandon and I were hunting public land in Potter County here this morning, first day of rifle season. We hiked in about a mile and a half. I think he went more like 2.5 miles, more like 2.5 miles. But I set up and I told him we got to be patient. It takes about, you know, till 9 o'clock till they get here, you know, from the guys pushing them from the road. And sure enough, at 9:05, four doe came in, you know, stood around a little while and then bedded down. They were bedded down maybe 5 minutes. And I heard a grunt coming from the south, and I saw the big doe stand up, and he came in and started chasing her around. She came towards me. Tough shot. He was coming right at me, and I did hit him. I got a little off to the side, got in the shoulder on his left side. When he ran off after the first shot, I yelled at him, and he turned broadside, but his head and shoulders behind a tree, and I stuck one in next to the tree, and he took off up over the hill. I couldn't get another shot. Brandon came to me, and we tracked him a little ways, and we heard him take off, so we let him sit for 2 hours. And then I went back after him again, and I jumped him. And a little while later, Brandon did a little push to try to find him, and he found him laying dead in the creek then. And all is good. Nice 8-point. Potter County mountain buck. Don't get a whole lot nicer than this. Really a lot of fun. Glad Brandon could be with me and again, and we're going to try to get him one. Thank you.
Well, folks, what a crazy weekend we had up here in Potter County. Yesterday, Dad was able to harvest that beautiful mountain buck. We think that buck is extremely old. Just had some unbelievable mass on him, and just an awesome mountain deer. They don't get as big as some of the farm-fed deer down near home, but that's an awesome buck. His biggest to date, so that's really cool. We actually ended up hanging him in a tree last night because we only found him about 3:30. And we were about a mile and a half in. Hung him in a tree, got down to about 20 degrees, so perfectly fine to hang him up. And then I hunted the first hour or so this morning, didn't see anything, and Dad headed down, and we started to skin the deer, and then threw the meat in some cheese bags and headed out. So it took us about 2 hours to get him out, so not an easy drag, but well worth it. What a deer. Our Uncle Dave actually shot a nice 8-point as well last night back at our cabin on public land. So as soon as we got back to camp last night, I headed in to help them. It's pretty quick. We had three guys helping, so it was an awesome weekend. Saw that really big buck while I was driving Friday, and then saw 7 deer yesterday, 2 junior bucks and a couple of does. And when Dad was walking around this morning, he actually saw another big one. He was running at about 300 yards, no shot, but he couldn't have shot it anyway. And if I was with him, I couldn't have shot it because it was through some thick stuff, and 300 yards is a little bit of a poke. But still an awesome weekend, beautiful out, just cold, crisp, clear. Couldn't ask for anything better. So another fun one. We'll be back at it again next weekend. I'll be with Grant in Tioga, and then most likely we'll be back up here in Potter the following week and the last weekend of the season. So should be a great couple of weeks, and we'll see you on the next one.